All right, so here's my garden. I got two long rows that I built. One of them's a little bit fatter than the other, and one of them's a little straighter than the other, but that's okay. So that's the garden complete. Now we're gonna hook up the drip line to it and get ready to plant. All right, so here's what I got. So I've got a sprinkler system that runs several parallel lines that run out in like an H pattern out in my backyard. Is making an access port so that I can use this sprinkler system to then irrigate my garden through a drip line. But to do that, I need to make myself an access tube. And what I've come up with is a couple pieces. I'm gonna end up threading this guy in there like this. I'll fix it to my timbers, which border the playset, and then I'll put a ball valve on top of here. That way I can shut it off when I want to. And then I'll end up likely putting another threaded piece, maybe a 90 on top of it so that I can run my drip tube that way. But I want to make it above ground, that way I don't hit it. It's still protected by this timber here, but it's big enough to where I can still see it. So that's the plan. All right, so I've marked myself a length with the saw blade there. I'm gonna try and cut this straight and not embarrass my dad here. I guess or my grandpa. What do you think, Dad? Straight enough? I think so. My dad is a plumber. When we go and visit job sites, that was one of the things he was always real critical of. How could somebody cut a pipe not straight like that and call themselves a man or say that they did a good job, take pride in their work? And I was always like, oh my gosh, Dad, no one's going to see it. It's gonna butt into this pipe. And it didn't matter. It was the principle of the thing. It was that you did the best job you possibly could, being the expert in the field that you were in. So that was kind of the work ethic that stuck with me, and I appreciate that. Quite possibly something else that you would have done is leave the whole thing long. But I'm gonna see, maybe this is as much as I need, and we'll go from there. So first step, cleaning everything up. Make sure there's no burrs on that. This guy's gonna slip on there real nice. Yep. Take some of my peak primer. They're all cleaned up there. Dry a little bit. I'll get both sides. And I'll get one side of my ball valve. Get my good glue. Oh, that's another thing. See how messy that got? Oh, actually, he used to always have a jersey glove, which I don't have jersey gloves on me, so I'll use this fancy paper towel. Probably a waste of a paper towel, but he would always clean the heck out of his joints. That way everything also looked nice and pretty. I thought that was pretty cool. A little on both sides. Probably too much. Get it in there and give it a quick little twist. It's in the ground, no one will see it, but that's not the point. So hopefully, if I'm gone on a work trip and Dad has to dig this up, he won't be disappointed. He wouldn't be disappointed. I'll just give him a hard time. Hopefully it wouldn't cause him frustrations, though. Actually, there we go. It this part will be above ground. So I need to make sure you are nice. Good looking. Cool, I'll let that dry for a minute. Put primer on nice and tight. It'll spill my box anyways, but I like to think that it won't. Put a little thread tape on, making sure that put it on so that it doesn't untwist itself as it's threading in. All right, that guy's nice and tight. Allow 15 minutes for good handling strength. All right, 15 minutes. Here's a project that we started before, and I filled in the gravel. So now all we need to do is put my elbow on there so I can screw in my hose to feed the drip line to the garden. So let's get to it. Going to hold it there for a few seconds. These glue joints have a tendency of rising up if you don't hold them there.
So here's how my system works. Right here, this is where I tapped into my sprinkler system, and it goes into this red hose. Thanks, Mom. I had a green hose here, but it just wasn't long enough for what I was trying to do. So we move down here, and I go from my red hose to a brass splitter. This is where the sprinkler system, or the drip system that I bought, ties into. These are the parts that came with the drip system. They come with a bunch of these adapters where you can cut this hose to length and then adapt it to a standard size hose fitting. From there, it goes to these manifolds, which again, you can cut the hose anywhere you want and then put these manifolds in, which provide you four drip tube options, which then go out to the different types of heads you can put. And I use all of the heads that they provided me. The first head that they gave us was this fan type head, and then it's adjustable by just turning this blue bezel right here, and it produces enough of a fan to sprinkle all my little species. So my marigolds there, my rosemary, my basil, I just put them about every 18 inches to just fan out across the little guys, including some of my peppers. And then we come to my bigger species, like my tomatoes. So my tomatoes have more of a dripper. So these little ports out there, I don't know if you can see that, they just kind of sprinkle out, and then I can sprinkle more or less. So hopefully the squirrels don't just chew my bezels up. And then if you're looking at my tomato plants thinking like, oh my gosh, you didn't water those, and those are some sad looking tomato plants. We got a really late frost that really eat them up about 2 days ago. I still have hope for them. We'll see if they come back. There's still some green in there. Maybe I'll get some more leaves on it, but we'll see. So more drip. This guy's a little close to the ground, so he fared better. And then when you come over here where we planted our sunflower seeds, we've got another type of drip. So this guy I think is meant for like a hanging basket or plants or something like that. And then you just turn the bezel right here in order to make have more water or less water come out. What I did is I put these in the ground and covered them up like that, and that way my whole trough here gets filled up with water. And I also use that for my pumpkin in there, and then my pumpkin here, and then my melon there. As you can see, I used the fan one there because I actually ran out. I prefer to have a drip one there, but the squash seems to be doing fine there. Or I'm sorry, the cucumber. I got a row of cucumbers that all seem to be doing fine. And I also perhaps spread these guys out more than I needed to, but that's okay. This is the first drip system I've set up for my own garden. And thus far, it's been operating for about a week. And I'm pretty pleased with it. The only thing I wish I would have done differently was, instead of buying one kit, buying two. I had to cut the hose there and bifurcate it to the other side. And I think it just would have been cleaner and easier to walk around if I would have had just two systems completely. And I could have ran one all the way down this run, and then another complete system all the way down this way. I think I prefer the drip ones over the fans, and that second system would allow me to put all drip in instead of having to use some of the fans. I think the drips are more efficient for my climate, but that's fine. It's still working and it's keeping my plants alive despite how good of a gardener I am. So next step is, I know I'm kind of doing it backwards, but next step is going to be putting weed barrier down because I finally got a hold of some good stuff. Until next time, thanks for watching.